My name is Vincenzo Mara. I was born in Rome. I came to the United States in 1971 after 40 years of career in this country. I can say, beside business, I was involved for 22 years with NIAF, National Italian American Foundation, which I became also regional vice president. I was all that time the assistant of Frank Stella, the column of National Italian American Foundation. Then I became the first ambassador for Sons of Italy under the leadership of Joseph Sciame, a great friend. And tonight we're here because we believe strongly in Casa Belvedere, any movement, whatever. People would like to speak a little bit of Italian. That's the mission of ILICA, Italian Language Intercultural Alliance. We welcome anybody who believes that Casa Belvedere has all the numbers to do so. Grazie e arrivederci.
Excellent, thank you.
I'd like to say that we'd like to present Italy of today, as well as the Italian-American experience. And basically, how do we do that? We do that through events like these, through culinary events, wine tasting events, presentations, book readings, anything that we can do to promote Italy of today. What you see here today is a 1908 Italian 8 villa that sits on 2.75 acres of land. The land and the villa was purchased by Gina Biancardi and her family. She has children. They go across the street at Notre Dame Academy. They fell in love with the property, and basically they purchased the property and then donated it to a nonprofit organization that they call Casa Belvedere. We're a very new organization. We initiated our programming in September of last year, and we started with an Italian language program because we felt that Italian language was at the root of ensuring that our heritage continued to thrive and be alive in this country. We also started an Italian culinary program as well. But the vision of this organization is ultimately to create an Italian cultural campus. And today it gives me great pleasure to this wonderful presentation of Terroni and Polentoni, Italian Southerners and Polenta eating Italians from the North. It's a debate by celebrated Italian authors Pino Aprile and Lorenzo Del Boca, which will discuss the age-old question that still haunts Italy today. Did the North or the South benefit from the unification of Italy? This evening is part of a series of events that have been posted at Casa Belvedere in celebration of the Italian Culture and History Month with its theme of the unification of Italy. The debate is going to be moderated by Vincenzo Marra, and who is the president and founder of the Italian Language Intercultural Alliance. And we have two able-bodied interpreters here. We have Angela Aurora Toscano, who is the lecturer of Italian and Italian cinema and coordinator of the Italian language program at Kingsborough Community College, to my right. And we have Ilaria Marra Rossiglione, who is also the translator of the book Polentoni into English. No, Terroni into English. I apologize. Terroni into English. Next time. That's soon to be. As I said, the book Terroni is all that has been done to ensure that Italians of the South became Southerners, and Lorenzo De Bocca's book is Polentoni, How and Why the North Was Betrayed. So, Terroni and Polentoni this evening is sponsored by the Italian Language Intercultural Alliance, and I want to thank Vincenzo Madra for doing this and putting this together for us. It is truly appreciated, and it is also supported in part by public funds by the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs in partnership with the City Council. So I give you Vincenzo Madra.
Sitting here, tell you immediately what ILIGA is all about. Italian Language Intercultural Alliance is born by a long experience within the major foundations in this country, National Italian American Foundation and Sons of Italy, where we came from, where we spend about 32 years of our lives. And then we decide that if we want to continue to call ourselves Italian American, we should also learn a little bit of Italian, and that's why we dedicate ourselves to the Italian language and culture. Stop right there. Why are we here tonight? Because we look with great favor to Casa Belvedere as a new formation for the 21st century Italian Americans. This tremendous investment is a new example of how we should start to behave. We are no longer people that meet under a building or we are rich. We got it there, finally, we start to behave in places like this, magnificent. So, hey for Casa Belvedere. As far as the book is concerned, we are going to get into this right away. In my right side, I have the author of Terroni, that is Pino Aprile. And in my left side, Lorenzo De Bocca, the author of Polentoni. Of course, one is from the south, Puglia, and one is from the north, Piedmont. So, now, we move fast.
Ricordarci da dove veniamo è troppo importante per dimenticarsi.
It's so important to remember where we come from. It would be a shame to forget.
E proprio perché è importante ricordarci da dove veniamo che io personalmente mi sono occupato della storia del Risorgimento.
I have made it my work to learn about teach about the Risorgimento for this very reason.
Storia che mi sono accorto non viene raccontata correttamente né nelle scuole inferiori né nelle scuole superiori neanche nell'università.
And it is not taught correctly in school. It is not taught in our elementary schools, our middle schools, or our high schools.
Ho dovuto invertire tutte quante le convinzioni che avevo e che mi erano state insegnate a scuola.
I had to reverse everything I learned in school.
E ho dovuto fare i conti con una storia totalmente diversa, probabilmente anche diversa da quella che conoscete voi.
And I had to deal with learning a history that was completely different from what I had previously learned and perhaps that you were familiar with as well.
Naturalmente raccontare un'altra storia, anche una storia poco gloriosa, non significa per questo sentirsi meno italiani.
Even if the history that is to be recounted is an inglorious one, it does not take away from the importance of being Italian.
La verità non può essere tricolore perché la verità non ha colore.
The truth can't have the same color as the tricolor flag because the truth has no color.
E quindi raccontare anche le cose poco gloriose, qualche volta addirittura le porcherie delle quali sono stati i protagonisti i nostri antenati, non significa sporcare la bandiera, ma significa per l'appunto valorizzare il nostro presente.
And it is important to tell the truth about our ancestors, even if it is not the most glorious one. It does not detract from its meaning.
Questo discorso va
quasi il doppio, insomma, molto più di quello che è durato il regno d'Italia con i Savoia, circa un po' più di 80 anni.
127 years, almost double, or maybe more than what the kingdom of Savoia lasted.
È quasi il doppio del tempo della Repubblica Italiana.
And just about double also the time of the Italian Republic.
E la ragione prima dell'unità fu il Piemonte aveva un sacco di debiti, il regno delle due Sicilie un sacco di soldi.
the reason before that the Piedmont had
lots of debts
and payments to be made.
And the people in Sicily had a lot of money.
I meridionali furono così contenti di essere liberati.
The Southerners were so happy to be free, to be liberal.
Che ci misero un po' di tempo per capirlo. E pur di non farsi liberare, presero le armi e combatterono.
So in order not to let them be free, they picked up their armies and started fighting.
They fought back, yeah.
E fu necessario convincerli bisognava essere liberati.
That is necessary to be free.
Ci vollero alcuni anni, circa una decina di anni, circa 10 anni di guerra.
They needed like at least 10 years of war.
Ma nei libri di storia leggerete che furono sterminati dei briganti.
But in the history books.
You'll read that brigands,
outlaws were killed.
Erano decine di migliaia.
Thousands,
tens of thousands
of outlaws. E molti di loro erano soldati dell'esercito delle due Sicilie.
Many of them were soldiers of the two Sicilies.
Per piegare la resistenza dei meridionali fu dato ai bersaglieri il diritto di stupro sulle donne del sud.
Okay, the right to free the south, they were given to the Piedmont army, the bersaglieri, the right to rape the women from the south.
E di saccheggio sulle ricchezze del sud.
And to steal all the rich.
Tutto l'oro del sud fu portato al nord.
All the gold from south were carried back to north.
Se dovessero restituirlo oggi,
if today would give it back,
qualche cosa più di 2000 miliardi di dollari.
And it would be more than 2000 billion of dollars.
Furono sterminati, bruciati vivi, fucilati in massa centinaia di migliaia di meridionali.
They were killed, burned alive, destroyed hundreds of thousands of people from south.
I primi campi di sterminio in Europa furono fatti per sterminare i meridionali.
First concentration camps in Europe were invented to kill all the people from south.
Quando la guerra finì, i meridionali liberati, piuttosto che godersi la libertà, fuggirono dalla propria terra per la prima volta nella loro storia. 20 milioni di persone.
When the war was over, for the first time in the history of the South, all the people that survived decided to escape for the first time in their history outside of their
20 million
of them.
Quest'anno hanno chiesto ai meridionali di festeggiare i 150 anni dell'unità d'Italia.
This year they asked to the southern people to be happy and celebrate the 150th anniversary with them.
La festa non è riuscita
bene. The party didn't come out as expected. But we'd like to stop Pino right here. Sorry if I interfere because it's a little bit difficult. The concept, I'm so new, right? So we are at this point, again, 2 points. One was Gabor spoke French, and he was French, and related to different things that were not Italy, but more to the economical side. Then, of course, the example between the Europe, putting together Europe, and the violence over the independent states and Italy to impose on them an idea. And the other side, we have the identity of the South, strong identity from the South, tremendous heritage from the South, and this ununderstandable attitude from the South not to be freed, fighting until their death to remain where as they were, and when they killed them all, they last escape. So This is the irony of the two approaches.
Tutti i soldi sono stati portati al nord. Tutti i soldi sono stati portati via, non al nord.
Just I would like for my therapist to expand on a concept that Pino brought to our attention, the idea that the money disappeared to the north.
O perlomeno bisogna intendersi su quale nord.
It actually just disappeared, or perhaps more specifically, it's best to specify which north.
Perché certamente molte persone si sono arricchite dalle guerre del Risorgimento.
Many people did become wealthy from the Risorgimento's battles.
Ma il paese come paese, cioè le istituzioni del nord, non hanno portato a casa un soldo.
But the institutions in the north really brought no wealth back.
È complicato spiegare nei dettagli, le percentuali, le cifre, non, è inutile che mi annoi.
It is difficult to explain in more detail because it risks to become boring.
Però questa cosa cerco di dimostrarvela con il terzo esempio che per l'appunto vi voglio raccontare.
But I'll try to explain it as best I can in this third episode I would like to recount.
Il terzo esempio ve lo racconto con un episodio che riguarda i 1000 garibaldini in camicia rossa che partono da Genova e, virgolette, conquistano il regno delle due Sicilie.
It concerns the 1000 soldiers that left from Genoa to conquer the kingdom of the two Sicilies.
Siccome non voglio soltanto criticare il Risorgimento, ma vedere anche dove c'è eroismo vero, dico che la maggior parte di questi 1000 ci credeva davvero.
I don't really mean to just criticize the Risorgimento. Effectively, there were certain people who really did believe this to be beneficial.
Erano convinti che l'Italia dovesse essere unita così, che per questa Italia bisognava spendere qualcosa e anche rischiare qualche cosa.
That they were convinced of the unification in order to carry it through, that there were certain risks that needed to be undertaken.
Ad eccezione.
In other words, he tells you, well, look, as Pino Grillo said, the North came and took everything from the South. Wait a minute, which North? The people that drove the thousand, the people that drove this revolt, the people that drove this great Risorgimento, okay, those who were fighting with ideals, they die in different fashion, insanity, suicide, and everything. Last but not least, the example, which is very graphic, of a man from the North putting a hangnail to his coat, saying, this is not the Italy I was dreaming of, so it wasn't from South, even the North of. So, bottom line is, as far as I'm concerned, North paid for this unification, and as far as I'm concerned, it's still paying for the unification, because only a few bankers made the money. So the ball goes.
Vi ringrazio naturalmente per essere qui con noi. And if you like what you saw, please tell everyone. If you didn't, don't say anything. Also, if you're not on our mailing list, please do so. The books are for sale, so if you'd like to purchase a book, all the books you all want. We have a request to give you, sir.
Two speakers, one saying, by talking about a flag, it doesn't mean that we dirty the flag. Probably we give a different view on the flag. If we keep saying that Italy was born in a certain fashion, and historical fact today tell us that probably there's a new version, well, we're here to discuss this version. That was Lorenzo da Bocca. On the other hand, Pino Aprile say, look, the South, where you all people come from, 90% in America, North America, was the richest country known before 1861, and the world then known. It was the most advanced in every fashion, in every field. So today, we didn't come here to celebrate something that you are not celebrating. We are here telling you, let's celebrate together, let's work together to make possible that Italy is going to be finally a family rather than two split countries.
So are you personally, as an expert in your own right, a pessimist or an optimist about Italy becoming more unified in, let's say, over this decade?
I think that Italy has never been divided. The people of Italy are all together. Trust me when I tell you that a Venetian and a Palermitano from Naples and Sicily, they love each other. The problem is with the interest. The problem is with the economics. So, if you take 20 nations and forcefully you change their route and try to change their currency and their money and their way of thinking, it's quite obvious that it takes some time. But the people inside, they were all happy. They never had this idea not to be united. So somewhere, somehow, we had to erase this conviction. The truth of the matter is, Italy, if we in America, especially in New York, welcome two people, one from Milan and one from Palermo, for us, they are not North and South, they are two Italians.
So either the speakers or yourself, to the extent that the problem exists at a certain level, do either they or you offer any practical recommendations to overcome the power interests that are...
The speakers are, one is from Piedmont and the other one is from Bari. So, the two, I'm from Rome, by the way, so we represent the unification with them. All of us consider ourselves friends, Italians. We are not even thinking about not being united. We are discussing certain different reasons that tell us probably that the history hasn't been always true to Italy and to these sons that were left. So we are trying to say, why don't we discuss the real history, and probably we'll be surprised because we will find a country bigger and better than we ever think or someone wants to tell us.
So you're saying a better knowledge of the real history will lead to a stronger Italy?
I'm not going to tell answer to this with my words. I'd like to take one of the best, maybe the best pen of the 20th century, Indro Montanelli. A country that doesn't know where it comes from will never know where it's going.
Thank you, Sandra.